This is the Hitachi inverter refrigerator control board. If it goes bad, I will give you repair tips for this control board. So first I will tell you where this control board electricity starts flowing. This connector has 3 and 1 written on it. Line wire should be installed on this 3 number pin. If the line wire is not installed on this pin, then this control board will cause problems. As if neutral will attach to this wire, the fuse will not pass electricity. And on the neutral wire, if the line is installed, it could damage the parts made for the neutral, because the ground is directly installed with the components installed in the control board. If this ground wire is attached in reverse, then it goes bad. A ZNR is installed further, which is a protection device. If the voltage passes above 260 volts, the fuse blows up to protect the rest of the control board. And the control board will not work. For filtering the electricity, further line filter and capacitors are installed here. A surge voltage device is installed at the back of the line filter, which is grounded with earth wire. As if the surge voltages came across this control board, they will pass it through the earthing wire. And the complete control board will be saved from damage. Normally the reactor or inductor in the DC inverter is used to store energy in DC and AC current. The output from the reactor will be AC current. This is an AC inverter. So from these pins over here, the inductor wires are taken. After filtering out through the reactor, they are actually converted to DC. Pin number 5 is the input. And the pin number 7 is the output. I didn't have a smaller reactor. This 8 amperes reactor can be used with this control board. A capacitor is installed here, which boosts the voltages of the circuit. The AC voltages being rectified to DC through the rectifier moves toward the capacitor, where the voltages are boosted. The voltages then flow to turn on the SMPS. Other than this, the voltages from the capacitor are flowing in the positive trace towards the positive pin of the IPM. This was the basic information about this Hitachi control board. Now let me explain to you when this control board goes bad. What thing could go faulty in this PCB? Which you will have to check. The first thing to check is its fuse. Whenever the overvoltages flow, the work of the ZNR is to keep an eye on the overvoltages. If the overvoltages pass through the control board, the fuse will blow up in the first place. This is how the rest of the control board is protected. If the fuse does not blow up and an electric surge passes through the control board, then always the switching IC is hunted by the electricity surge. Its number is TNY285PG, as the high voltages are passed through it. This IC will seem to be blown up physically or will be internally faulty. The second fuse is installed over here, which also needs to be checked. If this goes bad, still the refrigerator will not work. Other than this, the most chances are the chopper goes bad. As the overvoltages has passed through the switching IC, the overvoltages make the primary winding go bad. And if the primary winding goes bad, the control board will not work at all. Let me tell you what else needs to be checked in this control board. A cold grounding capacitor is installed here. If this capacitor also goes bad, this control board will still not work. It is better to replace it with a new capacitor, as due to electricity surge it has made the rest of the things bad. This grounding capacitor could also go bad. Let me tell you what other components could generally go bad in this control board. A defrosting relay is installed in it. Let me explain to you the work of this defrost relay. The pin number 1 and 3 on this connector are for the two heaters installed in this refrigerator. The electricity flows together to both the heaters. When the ice in the refrigerator builds up more than usual, the relay turns on to pass electricity to the heater. And when the ice is defrosted, then the relay turns off the heaters. This is how all the ice from the no frost evaporator in the inverter refrigerator is melted using electronics. Let me explain to you the rest of the main functions of this control board. Two microcontrollers are used in this control board. The reason for using two microcontrollers is that to make the IPM or compressor control system work separately. Other than this, the rest of the functions, like the communication with the door, and the rest of the functions should be done separately. Both these microcontrollers talk to each other through these optocouplers. One is receiving signals, and the other is sending the signals. Whenever the problem is with the communication of the refrigerator, check both of these optocouplers. Suppose one microcontroller is working and the other is not making the compressor to turn on. Then need is to check the optocouplers as no communication occurs between both the microcontrollers. Most of the time, the error is also shown. LED 1 is installed in this control board, which indicates the error code according to the problem in the refrigerator through a blinking pattern. The display installed on the refrigerator also shows the error. Then need is to match the error shown on the display with the error shown on the control board to verify whether the errors are the same. If they are the same or different, we can figure it out in both scenarios. To operate the microcontrollers, 27805 IC regulators are installed separately for both microcontrollers. 5 volts is the output of this regulator. This means these microcontrollers operate with 5 volts of input. 15 volts should pass through this capacitor. If 15 volts are not shown on this capacitor, then it means the circuit installed before the capacitor has a problem. These 15 volts flow towards these 3 smaller capacitors. And through these 15 volts, the IPM operates and starts the compressor. Voltages also flow on the low side of the IPM pins. 15 volts also pass on this low side pin of the IPM. The IPM pins on the high side are operated through these low-sided pins. To start the compressor. I hope you understood the basic of the Hitachi control board in this brief video. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.